sale. It's popping, look at the line.
It's going crazy.
Everyone pulled up and it's so exciting. We had a few people like call out, but okay, let me go show you what everything looks like.
Hi vlog.
This is Alex, this is Lindsay.
We're having a closet sale today.
Wait, can you show me your favorite piece? Like, each, can you show me your favorite piece that you're selling? Yeah, you go first.
Okay. He knew. He's like, okay.
Oh, wait,
favorite piece.
Whoa. Yeah, those are insane.
They're just vintage. Bell bottom 70s, silver studded. I think the weight's about 30 on them, and they don't fit me right, so unfortunately I have to part with them.
I might need them.
I never part with them.
They're so good.
I really like this vintage knit. Very granny.
Oh,
very
so
Lindsay. Maybe this one too.
I just,
shout out, Celsius.
No, I have
literally served and sponsored.
They sent
me. They sent me. But I want them to sponsor here.
Yes. Yeah, you can break up normal with this. Got this.
He's running.
Who are you wearing today? Give me a rundown of your fit.
This iconic girl named fucking Lindsay Mitt.
Yeah.
Have you ever heard of her? Have you ever heard of her? No. She's iconic. Nice to meet you too.
Give us a top to bottom.
Okay. So this is
born yesterday.
Oh yeah, the born yesterday vest. Okay, and then we have the scarf. What were you? Born yesterday, obviously. Then I have my mom's vintage little cargo skirt on. Some thrifted cowgirl boots, my poppy shades, and my clips that I make for my brand. Oh, yeah, that's all.
Okay, guys, so I have a few questions for both of you. Can you tell me how you got started in fashion in general?
I had my first internship. I guess that was the start. I was an intern in the Esquire fashion closet going to my senior year of college for the summer, and that kind of taught me all the ins and outs of the editorial world, and I'm so grateful for that experience.
Well, I got scouted to model when I was 14 at a Florence and the Machine concert. In terms of design work, it's something I've always wanted to do my whole life, and I was lucky to move here for school, and then it kind of just took off from there. The past 5 years have been incredible.
And I know like social media is a big part of your guys' lives. How did you get started on that and like on Instagram, and how did you build your following?
I went to school in Baltimore, and it was just not like kind of where I wanted to be, so I would come home a lot on the weekends, and I would, you know, dress up and have my dad literally run around our hometown and take outfit photos of me, and you know, he was really supportive about it, which was great, and it kind of just kind of blossomed from there.
It's kind of a bad answer, but it did happen like very organically. I've always been like obsessed with doing weird photo shoots. Like before Instagram was even a thing, I would force my brother to like take photos of me in awful outfits. But I'm lucky that, you know, people like what I do, and it's kind of just grown naturally. Yeah.
Okay, cool. So I want to know, like, what's your guys' five-year plan? Like, where do you see yourselves in 5 years? What do you see yourselves doing?
You know, I feel like the answer can change every day for me, because there's so many things I want to accomplish, at least within my life, within the fashion industry. But if I had to pick some goals for a five-year plan, I would say start my own creative agency, as well as kind of just build on what I've currently been doing. I guess this is like a manifest kind of...
Yes.
Kind of thing, but build on what I've currently been doing, you know, editorial stuff, and I don't know, I get so choked up on this question because there's like so many different things I could say, but I would say just, I don't know, following my dreams and the goals that I have in the fashion industry. I know that's kind of like a very broad answer, but there's a lot that I want to accomplish, so.
Wait, what kind of agency did you say?
Creative agency. So, like a 360 agency dealing with advertising, production, multimedia stuff, stuff like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're going to do it.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, and I feel like going off that, it's really hard to kind of make plans in this industry. Like, I feel like things kind of just come up that you weren't even expecting, and things just take a turn. So, of course, it's good to have general goals, but I think personally, I'm always kind of just going with it.
I feel like it's best to be open to whatever comes along and kind of ride that wave and figure out what can happen from there.
Because, like, especially, like, I mean, I'm sure you can relate to this. Like, I didn't even really know this is what I would be doing, like, in terms of my own brand and stuff, but COVID happened, and it was like, I didn't really have a choice. I think just going with the flow and seeing where everything goes, and just, I really want to always stay passionate about what I'm doing. I think that's my number one goal.
Very well said, both of you. Okay, last question. Maybe this will be, like, more of a funny one. Like, biggest fashion hot take right now?
or anything in the creative world.
I feel like my biggest fashion hot take is I want to bring wedge sneakers back.
Wedge sneakers?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I've been wearing like the Isabel Marant ones, and everyone's commenting like, "What the fuck do you think you're doing?" And I'm like, "I'm doing it."
I don't know if it's more of a hot take, but just seeing how trends cycle so quickly kind of, not that it irritates me, but I think it sort of just goes along with how fast things can change and builds into other bigger issues like consumerism and, you know, overproduction and things like that. So being mindful of how much we consume and what we buy and stuff like that.
Thank you guys so much for chatting with me and for being here today.
Thank you.
Hi, Miss Queen.
Say it again.
I said, hi, Miss Queen.
Hello.
What's up?
How are you?
What are you listening to?
I don't know. A playlist radio.
Do you like a, like, micro mini moment?
Sure.
You like mini skirts?
Yeah, why not?
I like this mini skirt.
I feel like I'm not giving you very much to work with. I'm so sorry.
No, it's okay.
I need more cash.
I kind of just, like, came up to you and randomly was like, hey.
Yeah.
So it's okay. Thank you.
How are you today?
I'm good. I'm great. How are you?
Good. What do you think about mini skirts?
I think they're hot. Like, okay. Miu Miu. Like, this is giving me Miu Miu.
Thank you.
Of course.
Or tennis.
Yeah.
Or
prep. Or like Gossip Girl. Hey, what's up?
Very good.
I'm liking this little diesel top.
Thank you.
I'm really liking it, actually.
Thank you so much.
How are we feeling?
Feeling good. I mean, I hope the rain doesn't come down on us, but yeah. I'm trying to get into the shop.
Yeah. Okay. Can you give me a quick little fashion hot take? Like, what you like?
The best is probably just like a white simple tank with like jeans or even just... Yeah. Regular leather pants.
Yeah, model off duty, like it's so slick and cool, like clean.
It never goes wrong.
It's so good.
Yeah, it never goes wrong. Something that I wouldn't wear, the motorcycle bags from Balenciaga, you know?
Yeah.
I've been seeing them a little bit too much lately.
They're everywhere.
They're everywhere. I don't want to, like, accidentally offend anybody.
No.
On the street, but...
Because, like, come on now. Like, that's the one thing, like... We're not liking about trends nowadays. It's like,
yeah,
everyone.
They go by so fast, and then
it's
like
rapid.
Next month it's done. It's gonna be a new bag.
How are we feeling?
Overwhelmed, but excited. It's crazy. So many people.
Outside, right? I know. I haven't even seen
people outside. It's the line down the block.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah. It's crazy.
Holy shit.
Well, actually, I'm feeling pretty good. I'm energized.
Just
give me like a quick little fashion hot take, something we like, maybe something we don't like.
Say it, Sam.
I don't like working so much.
And that is completely valid. Okay, like no one needs to see your toes out. Like, if you wear with socks, sometimes you can make them look. But then.
Not in New York. New York is not the place to have your toes out.
Yeah.
In the house.
You don't want New York basically on your toes. That's basically
it. Yeah, no.
Thank you guys so much for watching. Today's Pleasure Trail has been insane. And thanks to Avery. Special thanks to him because he saved the day because 3 of my employees called out. And it was like a whole thing. But anyways, let me know in the comments who you guys want us to do a closet sale with next. Your favorite creators, your favorite influencers, anyone. Also, your favorite New York City designers. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And we'll see you next time. Bye.